Sleep more.
No.
You wake too soon. The fever still burns away.
Let it burn, let it char to ash this brittling skull.
A dream disturbed you.
Inside my head. My head. There's nothing but dreams gnawing away my sanity.
Well, get that head of yours back on the bolster quick. Your little brain still rattles round, needs to keep polished and presentable. And find me some decent work to be doing instead of this. Here.
Ah!
This'll leach out the imps. Hold it fast yourself.
Oh, where I force my brow on a smelting oven.
Now you know how it feels.
Since the day I conceived you, I brought us both nothing but trouble. Now the devilment is spreading. My best worker killed at this door in mistake for me.
I'd have thought that was good fortune. For you, I mean.
I wonder. Fortune is an ass that brays with soft breath in my ear. Follow me, I say, lead on, and it turns its rear to blow less sweetly in my face. Falls with every time. Bloody battle on the Champ de Mars for the commission to say, rearm our bands with sacks. The master munition, a good fortune, yes, hard work, yes, what happens?
I know.
3 years of sleepless production.
And then glorious 1848.
One night in the Rue de la Paix, sabres and muskets in the hands of rebels, and the king is no more, General de Rumigny is no more, my consorts and cohorts no more, the revolution has come and all promises are revoked.
Ruin.
1,000 brass bullets, my saxhorns and saxophones to rust in their piles of rock, to spit back in splintered anger and pepper my body with their rusted screams.
Don't blame us. You're not always the innocent victim.
What?
A barb or a bayonet cot. You'll stumble and stick your ribs on it. A trench of slime. Oh, here trots Adolf and whoa, in he goes, head first.
Like the owl at dawn, I'm blinded by what illuminates others.
Here's 40,000 francs, the man says, so your workers are idle. Pay them a wage.
Yes.
Keep the factory open till the dust settles in Paris.
Indeed.
Thanks, you say, and off he goes. Then off he goes, that is, dies.
Come on, know that he would...
back comes the debt, because you scribbled your sanity away. Adolf Sachs, you proudly wrote on the parchment, a 40,000 franc gift, no more. A 40,000 franc loan. And the baying and heel-biting begin.
Bankrupt.
Bankrupt.
You're right. I cut your cord, I heard your cry, then found I could provide no nurture, no growth.
I sometimes wonder why you bothered. Your lips have clasped. Play soft on this glass. Let thy faint breath mist such dull gaze to bloom afresh thy poacher's eyes. For then I will know noontide sun has not kissed and killed the demon, else 'tis I who dies. If dreams are no more snared by shadowy night, your child falls prey to hounds of keepers, trampling, tearing in uneven fight my golden lame voice, disemboweling envious reapers. Did not the stealer steal but to live, and create wholesome fare from limp health? So to starved senses you were to give, slaking fare, and in time poison thyself. I am a canker upon your lips. I take my toll. Breathe once more, so you may stifle my soul.
Whooping and wailing, how could I ever have thought your impish voice anything other than torture? You are a temptress. You're nothing more than a miserable moaner. An ill wind. Fish of foul neither.
Give me air.
You want air?
Let me breathe.
Shock it down through your reedy throat. And belch a foggy blast through your brass horn. What a fool I was, eh, to believe the fine, fancy, smiling, smarming words.
Who do you mean?
Hector Berlioz.
Eh?
My champion.
Surely,
Majestic, he said you were. Rejoiced. Did he ever bloody well let your grace's joyful staves?
Damnation of Faust, he was going to.
He never did, he?
No.
And Rossini despised you.
He thought I was beauty personified.
Only after I'd worked on him, perhaps he was right.
Kastner.
Kastner, yes. There at the very beginning. Le Dernier Roi de Judah, your first public deflowering. Bless him.
He stuck with us.
Kept coming back for more, you mean? Not sated back for more and more, blind to your wiles, your cackling, cankering agony of sound, sucking very life on those who play in your taps and scraps of battered brass.
Kastner filled me with the breath I craved. You owe him more. Without him, you'd have had nothing more than a hollow carcass, stillborn, silent. You've begun to eat the poison victuals laid out by the association. Their lies you once spat out are beginning to gnaw at your spirit.
Perhaps they're not lies. Perhaps you really are just William Meikle's Tenaroon twisted and polished in my mind.
And what did you know of the Scotsman before the association fed you the thought?
I can no longer tell.
No.
And what of the watchmaker de Fontenelle? Didn't he create you 30 years before? And the Germans with their batiphone?
They have clouded your mind. Those were nothing more than bass clarinets, only you pulled me further into realms they could never imagine.
But did I borrow and plunder to create the monster they say you've become?
No.
For my alchemy has not turned brass into gold. My meddlings have created nothing more than a vulgar machine.
You are an inspired man, Adolf Sachs. You know that your work...
is no longer worthy of the name. Talking years to come will be of Carafer, Meikle, Saru, not Sachs, not Sachs. Can no longer be shared with such a bastard offspring.
No, you can't. No.
They claim to remember the saxophone. They can tangle with the demon.
No.
There. She's yours.
Oh.
The child is doomed to suffer. The child won't live.